Barbering is a craft and one of the oldest professions in the world. It's not only a job, it's a way of living. When you're a barber, you must know the history of what you're carrying and the social relevance of that profession.
I talk to God Almighty more than anybody else. Lord, I talk to God Almighty more than I talk to anybody else. But there's a thin line between praying and a crazy man just talking to himself. I am a stone traveler, got no place in this world to call my home. I am a stone traveler, got no place in this world to call my home.
He said, get down on you, baby, cause I ain't no rookie. I'll put it apart and I was born to boogie.
The name Figaro's comes from The Barber of Seville, an opera from Rossini. Figaro, the main character, was not only a barber. He was doing everything else in that city. He was living his craft as a lifestyle. And this is exactly what we do as barbers. So this new generation of barbers living the old school barbering as a passion and a lifestyle are the Figaro's sons. Barbers were the first surgeons, the first dentists, and the first tattooists. Back in the days, they were the only ones who had sterilized tools and sharp blades to give stitches and extract bullets. They would perform any kind of medical service. You can see in the colors of the barber pole, the red over the white stands for the blood over the bandages, and the blue represents the veins. Barbers did a bit of everything. They would help you look good with a haircut and shave, but they would also take care of your teeth and give you a bath if you needed one. Barbers were always on board when sailors would go on an expedition. They would take care of their health and hygiene. Those barbers and sailors had contact with indigenous tribes who were the first people with tattoos. So they had a big influence bringing the tattoo culture into the Western civilization. When tattooing was still illegal, it was already handled by barbers in the backstage of their shops, where already a lot of other illegal stuff were happening. Figaro's was born out of passion. Passion of being a barber, but doing it the right way. When I opened this shop, I thought this is something the city of Lisbon needs. We could offer men the possibility to have an experience that it's not just a haircut or a shave, but the whole atmosphere that surrounds you when you enter this shop. So to be able to do this, I had to find passionate young guys, teach them the craft, how to become master barbers, and enjoy the lifestyle of barbering. Paulus is the guy who joined first. Lil Johnny is the prodigy of this shop. Tommy is the handsome barber. John Sugar Brown Snow. Oh yeah, he's the charming barber. Bertus, he's the guy that goes out on a Friday night and will never know if he's gonna show up on a Saturday morning.
Well, I dig on it down about an hour ago.
Fabio is very passionate about the barbershop and about the barber lifestyle and what we do here. In other cases, he wouldn't quit on his career and the job he had before, because it was something that he had secured him for life, but he took the risk. And if someone is so passionate about one thing, you know that it's going to be a success.
City and night.
Paulus is the first guy that is going to come here in the morning and check if everything is ready to start the day.
I was working as an engineer, but I realized that I wasn't happy and I couldn't see myself doing that for the rest of my life. And I realized that cutting hair was something that made me happy and was something that I was really passionate about. So I decided to quit what I was doing to become a professional barber.
3 or 4 days after he started working here, he broke his leg. The shop was running and we had clients waiting for 3-4 hours for a haircut. I could see that Paulus was very motivated, but because of the accident, yeah, he just couldn't do it. So I decided to keep on going, and a few weeks later, I saw there was a client that came here for the second time in a very short amount of time.
On a Monday.
Yeah, this is the story of Lil Johnny. He was only 16 years old when he came here for the first time as a client, and I could see that his passion for barbering, for the craft, you could feel his vibe, and it was extremely positive. It reminded me of me at an early age of 16, 17 years old when I was doing my first haircuts.
The first time I came here, for a haircut. I had a very long hair and I got amazed by it. I really liked the shop. I really liked the haircut I got. It was awesome.
He was my first real student that I had to teach him from zero to become a master barber. And it's impressive because at his age it's not normal that you're so responsible and so skilled in a profession. So he definitely has barber blood.
The second time I came here, Fabio asked me if I wanted to become an apprentice. First, I didn't know what to say, but then I thought about it and I said yes.
Yeah, being part of his education and of his grounds to become a barber, it's something that really inspired me to teach other people, you know. I think in 20 years' time, he will be the best barber in Portugal, for sure, and perhaps one of the best barbers in the world.
Stripes around my shoulder, I got chains around my feet.
Quero cortar o cabelo, às vezes tenho o cabelo muito grande e gosto de cortar com o Fábio. E os barbeiros, os que me cortam o cabelo, também não são os que me cortam só o cabelo, são todos meus amigos.
On a Tuesday, got my ball.
Já recebi muita coisa deles, um chapéu, uma camisola, um voucher, um placar.
Knock me down again. I got stripes around my shoulder.
Jon Snow came here because we put on Facebook that we're looking for a barber apprentice. So we just passed by the shop to apply for the spot.
Before I became a barber, I was a cook in a restaurant nearby.
Jon Snow is a very hard worker. He works a lot to accomplish his goals. If you give him a task or something that needs to be better at, he will work a lot. He will work until he gets the job done.
I enjoy to work with my hands, but to be a cook was not my passion.
And when you're dead, you're done. So let the good time roll.
African-American barber shops, they had an important role back then because they were a place where the African-American community could gather. And that started because white barbershops, they used to have black apprentices. And those guys became barbers and they opened their own shops. Joe Louis, for example, used to be sponsored by a pomade brand. You have pictures of Elvis Presley being cut by a black barber in the 50s.
I'm talking about the good times. Well, it makes no difference whether you're young or old.
It's a one kind of old fashion. When you come here, not just only to cut your hair, it's like an experience. When you enter the shop, you are stuck. This kind of the experience. It's always like a 1 or 2 hours. In these 2 hours, you will forget everything outside of the shop. You just focus here, not only the haircut, also the culture.
Tommy Gunn. His name is Thomas. And we gave him the name of Tommy Gunn because he became a barber really fast. And he could just cut hair like on and on. He was always reloaded.
I knew the barbershop because I had a friend who worked here, Bertus. And I knew him about 3 years ago because we had the same ex-girlfriend.
I told him, well, we have been thinking about opening an academy, but this is the first year we're running the business, so we don't know yet when it's going to open. But we may have some vacancy to be an apprentice.
When I came here for the first time to talk with Fabius about being an apprentice, he said to me, yeah, you come on Saturday, but you have to bring men's pants, because I only use slim pants and skinny jeans. And I asked, what's men pants for you? Dickies. Do you have Dickies? No. So you go buy one and then appear on Saturday.
He was very dedicated, extremely passionate about learning how to be a good barber. And this guy is extremely perfectionist. He shaves fast, but still perfect. His haircuts take some time, but he has to nail it perfect. So I'm very happy with the way he works, with the way he grasps, the way that we are dedicated to this craft.
What I like about being a barber is that when I finish the haircut, I can look at the client and say to me, yeah, that's me who did it. That's me who did that haircut. It looks great. And it never gets boring because every time it's a different client with a different kind of hair, maybe from a different country or with a different story to talk about. And that's what I love about being a barber.
Just, I said short. Just, that's the only word I told him. I didn't want to say, maybe they are artists, you know, like cutting hair. And now I'm like that and I'm really happy with it, you know. I'm gonna marry you someday. Go ahead and wake up,
it's a brand new day. Angels, the Academy is a new project and the idea is to teach the old school barber craft to new barbers, women, men. Both genders can join the academy. I mean, we have different courses to teach barbers from zero to the stage where they're able to manage by themselves. And when I see people that share the same passion, I'm very happy to be part of their education process.
Eu durante muitos anos cortava o cabelo com uma máquina e usava o cabelo rapado. E numa dada altura apeteceu mudar e de passar aqui conhecia o sítio e achei que isto tinha alguma graça. E então decidi vir cá. Porque a gente quando vai para a idade estamos mais livres de fazer o que nos apetece. Acho que é um espaço que tem um conceito e uma alma, portanto... É natural que a gente, quando vem cá, se sinta bem. Todas as coisas que têm uma certa coerência fazem-nos sentir mais confortáveis.
The barber community, yeah, that's a nice expression to say what we are. I mean, as barbers, we leave this job, I would say 24/7 almost. We're friends. Above everything, we are all friends. And we're sort of a family. So the barbers know that when they're here, they're gonna work their ass off that day. But at the end of the day, we're gonna sit together, we're gonna chill out, we're gonna drink beers, we go for dinner together, we're gonna go play football. And it's a lifestyle, and it means more than just coming into work and leaving the work and going home.
It's too cool to go barefoot.
The experience of managing the whole Figaro's Barbers have taught me a lot about life, and also made me learn a few important things regarding work and regarding friendships, and also how important it is to keep your boundaries well limited. So you gotta be professional, but you cannot skip the part where you're also human. And being a barber is probably the funniest and craziest job, but also very rewarding.
You can bury my body in Detroit City in the morning rain. When I die, just lay my soul on a southbound train. When I die, lay my soul on that southbound train. Don't you cry, Jesus killed the pain. Bury my body in Detroit City in the morning rain. When I die, lay my soul on a southbound train. Oh, when I die, just lay my soul.